What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's your boy Nurse Bass. I'm back with the next installment of Mastering ABGs, paid for and sponsored by YouTube, a collaborative effort to not only help you pass those exams and those ABG questions, but to better take care of your future patient.
Are you listening?
Nurse Bass. Beast mode.
This is the last trial by five, the third and final type of arterial blood gas question that you could be presented with on a test. It's one of the more tricky ones, but if you can stick with me and follow along, I think I'm going to be able to help explain this in a way that'll bring clarity to you and that will help you crush those exam questions. Let's just go ahead and dive into the very first one. All right, guys, so for our very first fully compensated arterial blood gas question, here's what we are presented with. Our pH is 7.37. That is between 7.35 and 7.45. So we know our pH is normal. That's great. But we can't automatically assume that this is a normal blood pH because it is not. And every single fully compensated arterial blood gas question is going to look like you have a normal pH and that the patient has a normal ABG, but that's not the case. So it's always important to take a look at your other two numbers. CO2 of 51. CO2 of 51 is acidotic. So our CO2 is gonna go in the acid column. And then our bicarbonate is 28. Now 28 is above 26. So our bicarbonate is going to fall in our alkalosis column. Now, out of everything I've been teaching you guys about this tic-tac-toe method, you're probably looking at this and thinking, well, there's nothing in the same column as the pH, so what the heck do I do with this information? What I want to do is I want to draw your guys' attention to this top left corner. I've just added this in. I'm sorry it looks so small, but I'm going to explain what it means. What we know is that a normal blood pH is 7.35 to 7.45, okay? With the dead middle being 7.4. The way that you look at all of these fully compensated ABG questions, you look at that pH, okay? Right now, what we know is we are fully compensated, but we don't know whether we have an acidosis issue or an alkalosis issue. So what we have to look at is our pH. So 7.37, here's how you do it, is 7.37 between 7.35 and 7.4, or is it between 7.4 and 7.45? Which one is it between? Well, 7.37 is between 7.35 and 7.4. If 7.4 is the perfect blood pH, then you can hypothetically think anything less than 7.4 is trending toward a more acidotic pH. And on the other side, anything trending more toward 7.45 is trending toward a more alkalotic pH. That is how you look at these fully compensated questions. So since our pH is 7.37, we're trending toward, although it's normal, we're trending toward a more acidotic state. So what we know, because our CO2 and our bicarbonate are abnormal, we know that we are in a state of either acidosis or alkalosis. We're just trying to determine which. So because we are 7.37, we're towards a more acidotic state, we know that our patient is in a state of acidosis from that and that alone. And then at that point, since we know we're in a state of acidosis, all that we have to do is look at what is in the acid column. And in this case, it is our CO2. Therefore, we are in a state of respiratory acidosis. The only caveat is it's fully compensated. So as opposed to the last video where we were talking about partial compensations, where the body was trying, we had similar altered CO2 and bicarbonate levels. The body was trying to compensate, but it was just failing to do so. In these situations, although both numbers are altered and abnormal, the body is successfully compensating for that pH. That patient came in with COPD and was retaining all that CO2, for instance. The body is now successfully able to compensate and bring that blood pH back up to a homeostatic range. So in this case, we are fully compensated. It's this piece up here on the fully compensated questions that gets students. It is. So drill this into your memory. I cannot recommend that more. Let's go ahead and dive into the other four questions to help solidify this concept and bring it all home. So for our second question, our pH is 7.42. That's between 7.35 and 7.45, so we know our pH is normal. Our CO2 is 32, which is less than 35, which puts us in the basic column. And then our bicarbonate is 19, which is less than 22, so we're in the acidotic column. Here we are again. What do we do with this information? So whenever you get into this kind of situation and you're pretty sure that it's a fully compensated ABG, again, just look at that pH. Just go right back to it. 7.42 is above 7.4, pushing towards a more alkalotic pH. Therefore, we know, based on that and that alone, that we are in a state of alkalosis. The question again is, what's causing the alkalosis? So once you know that you're in a state of alkalosis, just simply look in the associated column. In this case, we can see the CO2 is the issue. Therefore, it is respiratory alkalosis. However, it's fully compensated respiratory alkalosis. And why is it fully compensated? Because our kidneys are doing the perfect job of regulating our blood pH back up to a normal homeostatic level. Let's dive into the next one. So here we are at our third question. Our pH is 7.39, which we know is normal. So we'll put that in the normal column. CO2 is 29, which is less than 35. So the CO2 is gonna go in the alkalosis column. And our bicarbonate is 15, which is much less than 22. So our bicarbonate is gonna go in the acid column. Here we are again, presented with the same situation. We know that we have a normal pH, but both our CO2 and our bicarbonate are altered. So we know from that alone that we are in a state of full compensation. So now we have to figure out whether we're in acidosis or alkalosis. Again, we look at the pH. 7.39 is less than 7.4, pushing towards a more acidotic state. So we know immediately we're in a state of acidosis. We look at that respective column and we see that bicarbonate is the issue. So we know we are in a state of metabolic acidosis. And once again, our body is successfully compensating. We are fully compensated. And how do we know we're fully compensated? Because that pH is normal. Let's dive into the next one. All right, so for our fourth question, our pH is 7.45. Not above 7.45, but 7.45, so it's normal. CO2 is 49, above 45. And bicarbonate is 28, which is above 46. Again, normal pH with altered CO2 and bicarb, so we know we're fully compensating. 7.45 is above 7.4. pushing more towards an alkalotic state. So we know we're in alkalosis. And what is causing our alkalosis? In this case, it's our bicarb pushing us towards metabolic alkalosis, but it's fully compensated. Guys, don't worry if it's not making complete sense to you. Grasp these fundamental foundational nuggets that I'm giving you on how to solve these problems. And just hit practice question after practice question after practice question, and it'll begin to come to you no problem. Let's dive into our fifth and final question. So for our last question, we have a pH of 7.41, which is normal. Our CO2 is 25, which is less than 35. So we're in a state of alkalosis. And then our bicarb is 20, which is less than 22. So we know that we're in the acid column. 7.41, above 7.4, pushing more towards a state of alkalosis. So we know our patient is in an alkalotic state. And what is causing this alkalosis? It's our respiratory system. So this patient is in a state of respiratory alkalosis. Something needs to be done about it, but they are, for now, fully compensating, hence the normal blood pH. So this was the third and final kind of question that you could get, ABG question, that you could get on an exam. But always keep in mind, whenever you're doing these things, what all of these numbers mean and how it relates back to that patient of yours that you're going to be taking care of. And guys, like I said, if you're not completely getting it yet, keep doing it. This is the method that I used, and I could be given a set of ABG results right now, and I could throw this out the window and not even need it because I've ingrained it in my mind. So take motivation and hope from that all of this is possible to retain, and soon you're going to be knocking those questions out of the park. That's it for the trial by five, guys. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I hope that it helped. Stick around for the next and final video where we summarize and recap everything that we've discussed on mastering ABGs. It's your boy, Nurse Bass, and I look forward to seeing you there. Peace.